Hello everyone, myself Mr. F.R. Syed. I work as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. The topic for my today's lecture is 0-1 Knapsack Problem. Now at the end of the session, the students will be able to solve the 0-1 Knapsack Problem using dynamic programming. As we know, dynamic programming is one of the problem solving approaches for algorithms. First of all, let us try to understand what the 0-1 Knapsack problem is. A solution to the Knapsack problem can be obtained by making a sequence of decision on the variables x1, x2, x3 up to xn. A decision on the variable xk involves determining whether a value of 0 or 1 is to be assigned to it. That is, xk could either take the value of 0 or 1. Now, following a decision on xk, either of the two states are possible. That is, first one, the capacity remaining equal to m and no profit is earned. In this case, xk value is equal to 0. And if xk value is equal to 1, in that case, the capacity remaining would be equal to m minus wk and the profit earned would be equal to pk. Now, wk and pk are the weight and profit associated with the object number k. Now, the remaining decisions on the variables xi other than xk need to be optimal with respect to the problem state resulting from the decision on xk. Otherwise, the remaining decisions on xi will not be optimal. This needs to be taken care of. Thus, the principle of optimality holds. Now, the ordered set Si is used where each member is a pair P, W, where P stands for profit and W stands for weight. I will first assume that S0 equal to the set consisting of a tuple 0, 0, where profit and weight values are 0, 0. Now, Si plus 1 can be computed from Si by first of all computing Si1. Now, what is Si1? Si1 is a set of all pairs P, W such that P minus Pi plus 1, comma W minus Wi plus 1 would belong to Si. Now, Pi plus 1 and Wi plus 1 are the profit and weight of the object number I plus 1. Then Si plus 1 can be computed by merging the pairs in Si and Si1 together. That is, by taking a union of the pairs in Si and Si1 respectively. Now let us first see now the dominance rule. If Si plus 1 contains two pairs, that is, first pair is Pj, Wj and the other pair is Pk, Wk, such that Pj is less than or equal to Pk and Wj is greater than or equal to Wk, in that case the pair Pj, Wj can be discarded. Now this is because of the fact that since Pj value is less than Pk value and Wj value is greater than Wk, so it means that profit is less and weight is more. So such kind of a tuple Pj, Wj is discarded. Now discarding or purging rules such as this are called as dominance rules. So with the help of dominance rules, such tuples would be eliminated. Actually, you can say that dominated tuples get purged. Now here Pk, Wk dominates Pj, Wj. We'll take an example of it. Let us suppose we have S2 containing the tuples 4, 6, 5, 8 and 6, 7. Then in that case, we can discard 5, 8 and make the set S2 contain as 4, 6 and 6, 7. Now, why does this happen? When we compare these two tuples 5, 8 and 6, 7, in that case, 5 is less than 6 and 8 is greater than 7, meaning the tuple 5, 8 consists of the profit which is less and weight which is more. So tuple with less profit and more weight is discarded. Hence, we can say 6, 7 dominates 5, 8. Now we are going to compare the Knapsack and the 0-1 Knapsack problem. That is, the Knapsack problem solved using greedy method and the Knapsack problem solved using dynamic programming. The first one, it is a fractional Knapsack problem, that is the one which is solved using greedy method, whereas the one that is solved using dynamic programming, it is a 0-1 Knapsack problem. In case of the greedy approach, The items are arranged in decreasing order of P upon W ratio, that is profit as to W ratio, weight ratio, and then the items are selected to maximize the profit. Whereas in case of dynamic programming approach, every item is either wholly taken or not taken at all so as to maximize the profit and find the optimal solution. The last point is, for a particular problem instance, the profit earned is comparatively higher. Whereas in case of zero knapsack problem, for the particular problem instance, the profit earned may be comparatively lower. Now we take an example where n equal to 3, p1, p2, p3 are 1, 2, 5 respectively, and w1, w2, w3 have the values of 2, 3 and 4, and m equal to 6, meaning the maximum capacity of the knapsack is 6. As we know, S0 would consist of the pair 0, 0, and we'll consider the first PW tuple, that is P1, W1, which is equal to 1, 2. Now this 1, 2 needs to be added to 0, 0. So hence we get S01 as 1, 2. Now the next step is to find S1. Now for S1, we are going to merge the tuples in S0 and S01. So therefore, S1 would consist of the tuples 0, 0 and 1, 2. After this, we are going to find out S11. To find S11, we first of all require the next P2, W tuple, that is P2, W2 equal to 2, 3. Now this 2, 3 would be added to each and every tuple of S1 and we get S11. So 2, 3 when added to 0, 0 gives 2, 3, and 2, 3 when added to 1, 2 gives 3, 5. The next step, we get S2, and the tuples in S2 are as usual found out by merging the tuples in S1 and S11. Now one thing to be noted, that as in case of S1 and S2, even by applying the dominance rules, none of the tuples get eliminated. Now when we are finding out the tuples for S2, we are going to merge the tuples in S1 and S11, and after making a union of this, these are the 4 tuples, and none of the tuples get purged or none of the tuples are eliminated. Our next step is to find out S21, but for S21 we need P3, W3. So P3, W3 is now 5, 4. So this 5, 4 is now added to every tuple of S2, and hence we get tuples in S21. So this is how 5, 4 when added to 0, 0 gives 5, 4. Then 5, 4 added to 1, 2 gives 6, 6. Then 5, 4 added to 2, 3 gives 7, 7. And when 5, 4 added to 3, 5 gives 8, 9. In this way we get S21. Now what about S3? We need to find out what are the contents of S3. Now the students are expected to think and write the answer to the following question. Are any tuples eliminated from S3 because of the dominance rule? If yes, mention those tuples. So now pause the video and write your answer. Okay, now as we know, this was S2 and this was S21. Now for finding out S3, we need to merge the tuples in S2 and S21. And while merging, we come across that there are two tuples 3, 5 and 5, 4. To which we can apply the dominance rule, and hence the answer given is as the tuple 3, 5 would be eliminated. The reason being, the profit 3 of this tuple and the profit 5 of this tuple, when we compare it, 3 is less than equal to 5, but 5 is greater than equal to 4, meaning the weight of this tuple is greater than equal to this tuple, and we know the profit is comparatively less. So because of this, the tuple 3, 5 would be eliminated, and hence we get in S3 the 7 tuples, that is the 3 tuples from S2, that is 0, 0, 1, 2, 2, 3, and the remaining 4 tuples from S21, that is 5, 4, 6, 6, 7, 7 and 8, 9. Now one more question, are any more tuples eliminated from S3? Now if yes, mention those tuples. Pause the video and write the answer. Now this is S3 consisting of 7 tuples 0, 0, 1, 2, 2, 3, 5, 4, 6, 6, 7, 7 and 8, 9. Now we are interested to find out which tuples could be eliminated. And the answer is these two tuples 7, 7 and 8, 9 are eliminated. Now, what could be the reason? Now, when we have started this problem, we said that the maximum knapsack capacity is 6. So, if 6 is the maximum capacity, we are going to consider only those tuples whose weight would come up to 6. So, hence, the tuples with weight value greater than 6, that is this one and this one, would be eliminated. That is, we can say that tuples with W greater than 6 are eliminated. Now, this was our example where we found out this S3 from S2 and S21. And after deleting these tuples 7, 7 and 8, 9, this is what we have in S3. Now, once again summarize this S0, S1, S2 and S3 in one slide. Now, with M equal to 6, the tuple 6, 6 in S3 gives the final result. The tuple 6, 6, it does not belong to S2. So, this concludes that X3 value equal to 1, meaning the third object is selected. The pair 6, 6 came from the pair 6 minus P3, 6 minus W3, where P3, W3 equal to 5, 4. And this 6 minus P3, 6 minus W3 gives 1, 2. And hence, 1, 2 should belong to S2. 1, 2, it also belongs to S1. Hence, we conclude that this 1, 2 came from S1 and therefore X2 is equal to 0. That is, the second object is not taken. And since 1, 2 does not belong to S0, we conclude that X1 equal to 1, meaning the first object is selected. And thus, we summarize the values of X1, X2, X3 equal to 1, 0, 1, meaning the first and the third object are selected to be put into the knapsack, whereas the second object is not taken. Now, this is a reference for the video lecture. Thank you.